If I could have your attention, please. We will try to get started, maybe even a minute early. I think that would be okay. With that, we'll start out with the prayer and pledge by Alderman Taylor. Everyone, please stand.
Yes, with me. Heavenly Father, thank you for the opportunity to be before the city of North Little Rock and its constituents to do the city's business. Lord, we want to say a special prayer for the folks in Mayflower, Arkansas, and Valonia, Arkansas, that you be with them, be with their families and their loved ones, and see them through this tragedy. And most of all, Lord, help us to make the wisest decision that we can for the city of North Little Rock and for our constituents. In Jesus' name we ask this prayer. Amen.
Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
So moved.
Second.
On the motion.
I need to do the roll call. I need to do roll call.
Go ahead, roll call.
Ross.
Here.
White.
Here.
Taylor.
Here.
Robinson.
Here.
Baxter.
Here.
Fouch.
Here.
Height.
Here.
And Witcher.
Present.
Quorum is present, Your Honor.
So moved.
Thank you. On the motion.
Ross.
Yes.
White.
Yes.
Taylor.
Yes.
Robinson.
Yes.
Baxter.
Yes.
Fouch.
Yes.
Height.
Yes.
And Witcher.
Yes.
Okay. We have a special presentation tonight that I'm really excited about. Our 2014 high school state boys champions from North Little Rock are here, and I had the opportunity to meet them in my office and give them a proclamation making it their individual day. But I wanted Coach Rice to and the team to come up, and Coach Rice is going to introduce each one of them individually. I want to give them a hearty welcome and thank you from the city of North Rock. We'll get a group picture made and then let them go do what high school kids do. So, Coach, take it over.
Thank you very much. I wanted to say before I introduced the guys that thank you so much for the support of North Little Rock. I can remember before the game started, just kind of get a glance of looking around, and you know, there's 6,000 people there and a lot of North Little Rock people, and for some reason I just kind of glanced up real quick and I saw the mayor there, and that makes you feel good whenever your mayor's there supporting you, and so it really, really made us feel good, and I just want to say I appreciate it. I know there's others that were there. For some reason, Mayor, you kind of stuck out there. I kind of glanced at and we really appreciate it. But first I'd like to introduce sophomore Adrian Moore.
Adrian, come up, and we'll group up right here and take one big picture. Adrian Moore.
You're going to do one at
a time. Okay. Yeah.
Derek Holloway, senior Derek Holloway.
Senior, we're going to miss you, Derek.
Oh, yeah.
Senior Juwan Eldridge.
Another senior. How many are we losing, Coach?
We're losing five.
Five
seniors. Senior Chibu Ike.
Chibu.
Junior Sam Duncombe. Junior Cambrian Dickerson.
Feel like a little guy in here.
I think he's bashful.
Junior Kayvon Allen.
Razorbacks.
Yeah. Our last player is, we're losing to the Razorbacks there, is Anton Beard.
Go Hogs, yeah. Anton, go Hogs. Let's hear it for these guys.
Also have assistant coach Nathan Claiborne.
Hey, Coach.
Cannot do anything without him, I promise you. He's my right-hand man, and really helps a lot. Real quick, there we have some that's not here. Got one that was out of town, and then some other engagements. Got freshman Jarvis Ricks, junior KJ Hill, sophomore Kane Gunnett, and senior Khalil Gully that were not here, but I wanted to recognize them real quick.
Well, I want everyone to please notice, and all of you at home, that all of our council are wearing champion t-shirts tonight in honor of you guys. I made the comment earlier to these young men that I was asked last week at the I was giving a speech, and the question was, do you think the success of the North Little Rock athletic program is affects our city? My answer was absolutely. It gives these athletes a reason to get up in the morning and study hard, and it touches their classmates and encourages their classmates to be a part of a winning team and a winning organization. So I told them I was very proud of them for the hard work that it takes to be an excellent athlete. And, of course, a great coach doesn't help. I mean, does help. So thank you, Coach, for what you're doing. Squeeze in, guys, a little bit. Let's all get – see, we're up here on TV right now, so we want to make sure everybody can see you at home. Good deal. Thanks again so much. Appreciate you. Okay, I'm going to stay down here just for a little bit. We have another presentation. Suzanne Jackson and Herman Shirley are here with the History Commission, along with our director, Sandra Taylor Smith. And Herman's got some special little presentation, and he and Suzanne.
You know, we've got another winning team here. We've got the North Little Rock History Commission, and I don't think any other city in the state of Arkansas has a real active, ongoing history commission. So we try to collect history of North Little Rock. For about the last 10 years, we've been making interviews of long-time citizens, those families who have been here all 100 years on back, and we've made recordings of the memories of some of those people, and these are in our archives. I'm sure it'll be more valuable as time moves on. And we're here tonight to recognize a couple of families. We've got two categories. One is called Centennial Family, and that's those that have been here 100 years. And then the other thing is a early settler, families that have been here 75 years. And so any of you out in the audience or in the TV watching audience, if your family's been here that long, we want to know. And just call the History Commission and we'll get the necessary information, and then we'll make an interview. And you can tell your tale about how your family got here and why. And my experience has been, when you ask why'd you come here, those especially 100 years ago, to work for the railroad. This is truly a railroad town and always will be, I think. First, we want to talk about the Davis family. Lewis and Mary Davis brought their family to North Little Rock in around 1880. And they had a son born in 1889. His name was Aubrey August Davis. He was born over around 9th and Magnolia Street. And he went by Gus. And in 1917, he joined the Army. There was a war going on then. And they sent him to France, and he served over there until 1919, and the war was over, and came home and married his sweetheart, and went to work for the Rock Island and Missouri Pacific Railroad. In 1937, Mr. Davis was elected as a member of this city council from Ward 1. And he served for about 10 years in that capacity. And during that time, he formed the first police commission and served on as chair of that, and then pretty well wrote up some plans for retirements for the police force. So he was very active, and when a mayor at that time got called into active duty in the military, he served as a acting mayor for a short period of time, Mr. Gus Davis, and we're proud of him. This family had been active members of the Presbyterian Church even before it was the North Little Rock First Presbyterian. It was called Argentina then. And they continued to be very active in church work. And let me see. And at this time, I'd like to call on up here the only surviving member of this family that came here so long ago, my good friend Aubrey Davis. Come on up here, Mert. If you need some help, we'll take your time.
Let's hear it from Mert Davis. Mert, let's get a picture with
all right, stay here, Mert, for a minute.
Hold on. You want a picture of Herman?
Yeah, we're going. Yeah, but don't let him leave.
All right, don't leave. Come up.
Okay. All right. We'll
yep. There. Suzanne. Use a microphone.
They have a son who's lived in North Little Rock for many of the years, and so we're given two of the certificates, one for Mert and one for his son.
Bruce.
And anybody of age that still lives here is entitled to get a certificate. I'll talk about this girl that he married later on. Mert and I graduated from high school together. He was chosen to be the most popular boy in the senior class of 1946. I didn't give him any benefit when he joined the Army, though, I don't think. Four of us joined the Army, and we served our 2 years. And when Mert came back, somehow he looked up this pretty cheerleader and married her. We're going to talk about that lady a little bit later. So, Mert, congratulations with your family on being not only a centennial family, but gosh, what is 1880 to now? That's almost 150 years, isn't it?
Long time.
Yeah, sure is. We appreciate the work.
It's a great family. They happen to be my aunt and uncle, by the way, if anybody doesn't know that.
You gave up our secret now.
I'm sorry.
Okay, you can just stay up here, Pat. Uh, 66 years. Good.
Yep.
Great. Heavens. All right, this second family, they had the smarts to move from Little Rock to North Little Rock in 1937. And they had two children. It was G.L. Smith and his wife Margaret, and their son was G.L. Jr. And then they had Patsy Joe. Patsy Joy, yes, that's right. Mr. Smith was an electrician with the Missouri Pacific Railroad, worked over here in the shops, and he was also very active in their union at that time. When the war came along, he was in the Navy. He was fortunate enough to serve on Iwo Jima. Anybody remember? That was one of the toughest battles of all times in the Pacific Theater. He returned to his work after the war, and he was involved in Masonic work and the Gordon Gale Post of the American Legion and the Bering Cross Baptist Church. And now let me tell you a little bit about their daughter, Patsy Joy. Or some call her Aunt Patsy. I just call her Pat. When Mert returned from the Army, of course, he found her and married her, and they've been together, how many years? 65 years. For many years, Pat was a volunteer at the old Baptist Memorial Hospital up on Fort Bruce Hill, and then she became a member of the first North Little Rock History Commission when it was organized, and it lasted 8 or 10 years and then kind of disbanded, and then we got it started again. And so she was active in that time when they published the first history book of North Little Rock. And, she's been very active in that. Her older brother, G.L. Jr., attended North Little Rock High School, and then when he graduated, he joined the Merchant Marines and served in that capacity, and when he finished, he was offered a special scholarship to the academy, but he returned to North Little Rock to get married, too. He didn't want to be a work at the railroad, so he started looking for a job. Jobs were hard to come by then. But he found the job as a patrolman for the North Little Rock Police Department, and they put him on patrol down on Washington Avenue, one of the best beats, I guess, in town, Joe. And he served that well, and he gradually worked his way up, slow by slow, over the years, and became assistant chief of police. Then we have a situation where a son was born to this marriage along with a daughter, and the son went through high school here, went to university and graduated, and then had a degree in BSBA degree, and then worked for a while for businesses around here, and then decided to come to work for the city of North Little Rock. And for about 25 or 30 years, he served in various capacities, and then last January he was elected mayor. So it's commission's privilege at this time to present the Smith family with a early settler certificate for both Joe and Pat and Phyllis. So,
thank you so much. This was not planned, by the way. I didn't know anything about this, so. It's special. I certainly will. My sister will be so sad she wasn't here. One quick picture, Nathan, then we'll get through and get on with our city business. Thank you.
This is work for both your families here, by the way.
Thank you. All right, y'all be safe. Okay. Herman, thank you for all you do for the History Commission. Suzanne is the chairman. Y'all are wonderful, and we hope we're going to do great things down there in y'all's building. So, I think let's go right on into communications. Anybody want to pull any communications? Seeing none, how about a motion, Mr. Fouch?
Number 2 and 3, just as a review.
All right. Read them all, then.
Yeah.
Read them all, Linda.
The entirety of my title.
Just by title.
Communication number 1 from Karen Scott, Finance Director, regarding the first quarter liens and code enforcement fines collected.
May we accept the file?
Second.
On the motion.
On the motion. Rawls?
Yes.
White?
Yes.
Taylor?
Yes.
Robinson?
Yes.
Baxter?
Yes.
Fouch?
Yes.
Heitz?
Yes.
Witcher?
Yes.
Number two, from Warren Atkins, Solid Waste Service Manager. This is from the City of Little Rock, Public Works letter to Harold Ford regarding the CPI increase for disposal as outlined in the current contract.
Mr. Fouch?
Do we know what kind of impact this is going to have on the budget? I mean, it's per ton. It's only a dime per ton. But is there any idea? I mean, will it impact us enough to make a big deal?
No.
Okay.
I have a motion.
Move to accept and file.
Second.
On the motion.
On the motion. Ross?
Yes.
White?
Yes.
Taylor?
Yes.
Robinson?
Yes.
Baxter?
Yes.
Fouch?
Yes.
Height?
Yes.
And Whitaker?
Yes.
Number three, from George Wheatley, Waste Management, to John Roberts, Pulaski County Regional Recycle and Waste Reduction District, regarding rate adjustment effective April the 1st, 2014.
And again, question. Will the customers see an increase for this from Waste?
2 cents.
3 cents.
3 cents.
3 cents.
3 cents.
Move accept and file.
Second.
On the motion.
Ross? White?
Yes.
Taylor?
Yes.
Robinson?
Yes.
Baxter?
Yes.
Fouch?
Yes.
Height?
Yes.
And Whitaker?
Yes.
Okay, I'm going to jump around real quickly. I've asked most everybody if it's all right. 01441 Alderman Heights legislation. The gentleman here has to catch a plane, so we're going to try to do that. So, Charlie, I assume you want that called?
Please call it.
This is an ordinance granting waivers to allow variances and utilizing two existing pylon signs as off-premise signs on certain real property located at 5105 Warden Road in the City of North Little Rock, Arkansas. First reading.
I move that we waive all readings.
Second that.
On the motion?
On the motion to waive all reading, Ross?
Yes.
White?
Yes.
Taylor?
Yes.
Robinson?
Yes.
Baxter?
Yes.
Fouch?
Yes.
Height?
Yes.
And Whitaker?
Yes.
Do I have a motion to adopt?
So moved.
Second.
Mr. Taylor?
I'm wondering, well, I guess my question is, why are we not going with the monument rather than this pylon?
Well, one of the reasons is that along the interstate there are the divided highway. We've made exceptions for companies for signage, and even though it may be an overlay district, all along from even really from the street in Sherwood, Wildwood Avenue, all the way up to McCain Boulevard, most of the, if not all, the businesses have got tall, brightly lit signs. This particular location, I was going to ask the applicant, did I answer your question?
It did.
Okay, good. Since the applicant's up there, I was going to ask him what he's going to do about all those trees out on the front.
That are blocking the sign.
You can't see the signs for the
you
trees.
You cannot see those.
I'm sorry. Is your question answered?
It is.
All right. Do we have a motion?
Motion.
And a second. On the motion.
On the motion to adopt. Ross?
Yes.
White?
Yes.
Taylor?
Yes.
Robinson?
Yes.
Baxter?
Yes.
Fouch?
Yes.
Height?
Yes.
And Whitaker?
Yes.
On the emergency. Ross?
Yes.
White?
Yes.
Taylor?
Yes.
Robinson?
Yes.
Baxter?
Yes.
Fouch?
Yes.
Height?
Yes.
And Whitaker?
Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you for the approval and accommodation.
Go catch your plane. Thank you. We're looking forward to y'all being a citizen of North Little Rock.
I know.
Okay, let's go back now to, we have a special call. I'm going to call that, and then before, we have a public hearing, I'm sorry. Public hearing tonight on your deal.
Mayor, the applicant has requested that we withdraw that ordinance, and he's going to look at some other location.
Okay, it's my opinion, with my lawyer's hat on, that we probably need to call that public hearing anyway and close it. Council, if you got a good feel on that, go ahead and. All right, I'm going to call it public hearing, call it to order, and tell everyone, as Mr. Witcher said, he's pulling that legislation. And is there anyone that wants to speak? Seeing none, we'll close that public hearing. Okay, we did that.
Okay.
Good. Let's go on to...
And for the record, Alderman Witcher is withdrawing that
yes.
ordinance.
Yes, Mr. Fleming.
For the record.
All right, let's just go to unfinished business, and actually, we need to go to comments on the sign-in sheet. Sorry, y'all, we're bouncing around so much. First person signed up here is John Santoro on R1466. John?
Mayor, City Council, John Santoro. What this is about is we're talking about this fire department again. And I want to read an article in the Arkansas Democrat Gazette. This is Mayor Bill de Blasio from New York City. He said he is not acceptable that an ambulance took more than 10 minutes to respond to a fire in the Queens that killed two small children during the weekend. Now that's 10 minutes. And I know we supposedly did a study and it takes about 8 to 10 minutes drive time. I can tell y'all, I have driven it. It takes at least 8 to 11 minutes driving. So that is probably actual. Now, that's not getting the 911 call. I've called 911 many times out there on different situations. And we have been directed to Scott. We've been sent to Lone Oak, State Police. We've been sent all over. Add another 2 minutes there. Then you got to get the guys the right calls there. Then you got to get the guys in their boots, because they're not sleeping in their boots. They got to get in the truck. Then they've got to get out of the truck, put the hoses out. You're looking at 20 minutes on a fire. I don't see any way they can get there any sooner, even if they drive there in 8-10 minutes. They still got to get hoses and get the calls. So you're looking at 20 minutes. And saying that, I appreciate our two aldermen for the work they're doing on this situation. The rest of you can go to sleep at night, don't have to worry. I've got two small kids. This was two small kids in this fire here in New York. A lot of you got grandkids and got young kids also. It's something to consider. And this is a serious matter. We're not trying to be a thorn in the city. We're not trying to keep bringing this up over and over. This is serious business. And we're not talking, you might have read, it's not about a speed bump. It's not about a pothole. This is a serious, very serious issue that we're bringing up here. And again, we're not trying to be a thorn. We think this is a very serious legitical response here. Now, if you take pretty things like, forgive me, Alderman Height, bike trails, you take bridges, pretty parks, and put them on a scale and put a fire department on it, it ain't even close. Fire departments very much outweigh them. So that is our issue, is we feel like there needs to be something done, it needs to be budgeted, it needs to be somehow, it needs to be in the agenda. So therefore, that's what the study is about, and appreciate your concerns, and if you'll seriously look at this for us also.
Thanks, John.
Thank you.
Ms. Beeman, I'm going to call you up when we have your legislation. Is Ms. Beeman out there, Jacqueline? Yeah, I'm going to call you up later, okay? Gerald Paulton, Willow Beach?
Mr. Mayor, City Council, first of all, I'd like to say thank you to Alderman Taylor and Alderman Robinson for putting this forth, the RFP. John said it as good as I could ever. I do want to add just one little thing. As a person who's owned businesses in multiple state, multiple businesses, and retired military, I've always learned that one thing happens, and that is if the safety and security of the people around me is my number one concern, then I fund that first and foremost. Now, with that being said, I can't add anything more than what Mr. Santoro said. Hopefully, this gets passed, and hopefully one day we'll have an operational fire department in our area on the east side. Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you. Stephen Hart, R1466.
Mayor, Alderman, Stephen Hart, thank you for listening to me at this time. We had a meeting about 2 weeks ago, and I think the mayor remembers that meeting. At that meeting, we were told that we would not get a fire department. I am a new person to move to North Little Rock, and in our area, we do not have start this over. I have had the fire department come to my home, and it took them longer than 8 minutes to get there. On my property, I take care of all my property, and I feel like as a mayor, North Little Rock cannot grow nowhere but east, and I feel like east is being neglected and not taken seriously. And I myself really don't understand that with being a mayor. I want my whole area that I am over to look nice, or be satisfied with what's going on out there. I know that we were just talking about a fire department, but any issue that we have been trying to get in the alderman, I want to say thank you to Maurice Taylor and Ms. Linda Robinson, because they have listened to us and brought this issue up. But I feel like that we are not being taken seriously in East North Little Rock, and I think that with the right focus that we can all be satisfied with what's going on. But right now, East, we're not satisfied, far East, because we don't have the facilities to take care of our neighborhoods that we need. Thank you.
Thank you. Patrick Benka?
That's correct. Mayor, Council, my name is Patrick Benka. I'm an attorney here in Little Rock, North Little Rock. I live in North Little Rock. I'm actually a neighbor to Steve Hart, and he does keep his property in check. I've never seen anyone who can keep his property as nice as his, but that's not why we're here. Obviously, there's a proposal with regard to the services, and right now, the only thing that's before this council is whether you're going to consider giving a service as a consulting firm to figure out whether we do need a fire department out there. It seems to me that just looking at it, based upon the times from getting from point A to point B, that it needs to be taken in consideration. We live out there, there's not the facilities out there, and if you actually take a look out there, there's a whole lot of houses out there and a whole lot of tax money that's being paid from those houses and from those people who occupy those homes, and they deserve to have the safety and a fire department in the place just like everyone here does. And I don't think that a proposal or a consulting firm is going to cost that much money. And before this council can make a decision, before anyone else can make a decision, you have to have all of the facts. You have to have as much information so you can make an informed decision. And in order to do that, it seems logical to me that you would have a consulting firm come in here and give you, everyone here, as much facts as they possibly can with regard to how long it will take for someone and a fire truck to get from point A out to where we live. I think it's good, a good idea just to get all the information up front. That's all we're asking at this point in time. I think that's the only thing. We're not asking for a fire department at this time, although eventually I think that we will, but the consulting firm will help provide you with enough facts in order to make that decision at a time that it becomes appropriate. So I thank you for listening to me, and hopefully that passes without a hitch. Thanks.
Thank you, Counselor. Bob Harden, I'm going to hold off on you until we call that legislation, okay? And, okay, that's all the public comments that we have there. So now let's go back to unfinished business. R-1460, I believe.
R-1460, Mayor Smith.
Linda, hold on just a second. I want to recognize we've got some guests in the audience, the Boy Scout Troop number 427 out of Immaculate Conception Church. You guys stand up and let us tell y'all how much we appreciate y'all coming. Thank you. Okay, on R-1460, I'm going to hold that. I think we've got everything worked out to satisfy us. We'll try to let you know before the next meeting. And the gentleman that understands it on the Verizon Arena side will be here at the next council meeting. So if you got any questions or comments, be sure and address them to our city attorney. 01438, Linda, you want to call that so Murray can officially pull it?
01438,
call it, please.
You going to pull it, Murray? I mean, that's the one on the
contract. I'm sorry. Yes, pull it. Okay. I'm looking at another.
Okay. All right, new business.
New business. 1465, Mayor Smith.
Please call it.
This is a resolution authorizing the mayor and city clerk to enter into a mitigation credit acquisition assistance agreement with Richmond Holdings, Inc.
Move for adoption.
Second.
Bob Harden's here, attorney, has been working with our attorneys. Bob, you want to come up and answer some questions for those that don't get what it is? Mr. Fouch?
Well, I understand the premise behind all this, and I'm all for expanding jobs and work opportunities. I'm quite flustered by this paperwork drill for $57,000 that this new owner is going to have to pay for wetland credits. That to me is just like the carbon credit scheme that was up many years ago. If we can build on there, we should be able to build on that property, period. But it doesn't keep me from saying yes to this. I just want to put my, I think it's a stupid thing.
Okay, so you want that comment to go straight to Washington, D.C.?
Absolutely.
Okay. All right, any other questions for Councilor Harden while he's up there? If not, we have a motion and a second. On the motion.
On the motion, Ross?
Yes.
White?
Yes.
Taylor?
Yes.
Robinson?
Yes.
Baxter?
Yes.
Fouch?
Yes.
Height?
Yes.
And Witcher?
Yes.
Thank you, Bob. Be sure and tell Sid we wish him luck on the development. Okay, R-1466.
A resolution directing...
Hold on a minute. That's not mine. That's Linda and Mr.
Taylor and Robinson.
Mr. Taylor and Ms. Robinson.
Please call it.
A resolution directing that a request for a proposal, RFP, be issued seeking the services of a consulting firm to review and provide an analysis of the fire department's response times and services.
Do I have a motion?
So moved.
Second.
Comments? Seeing none. Ms. Robinson.
I'd like to make a comment. Having an analysis done on fire departments is nothing new. Matter of fact, surrounding states like Oklahoma, Texas, Missouri have had analysis done looking at various things, you know, whether or not they needed a fire station, locations, time. And so this is nothing new. And Alderman Taylor and I said we needed the facts. And we needed to be able to present the facts to this council so this council, you know, can make an informed decision. So hopefully, you know, you all will approve this for us to do this.
I have a question then.
Go ahead.
Since Alderman Robinson, since you're aware of that there's been other proposals done in other states, what kind of cost for those proposals can we expect?
Well, I spoke to one who conducted a study in Oklahoma City, and that study was conducted back in 2008, and I think that cost was probably around $20,000. You know, however, Oklahoma City is much larger than North Little Rock.
Ms. White?
I just have one question. Would this only be done for the eastern part of the city, or would this be for the entire city?
It would be for the entire city, and what the study may show is that there may be some redundancy in some areas, that we may have too much coverage in some areas, we may have not enough coverage in some areas, or we may have some holes in some areas. So it's just gonna give us a clear vision of what our coverage is, what our coverage should be, so we can make an intelligent decision as to how to move forward, making sure that we get the proper coverage in the eastern part of the city.
Ms. Ross?
I'm just curious, once you put the RFP out, which I'm assuming will go out pretty soon, how long before you get back to the council, when will we know when this is going out, and how long does it take them to, I'm just curious how long this is going to take the whole process?
Well, it'll take us probably 3 weeks to 4 weeks to get the proposal drawn up. and put out. Then it would probably take another couple of weeks to get proposals in, and then our selection committee will have to decide which one, and then we have to find, we'll negotiate a cost, and then we'll come back to the council to appropriate the money to pay for what we've negotiated to.
And then they do.
So I bet it's going to be 3 months. That's what I bet.
Do you, when you do this RFP, I'm just curious, on something like this, do you give them a timeline, say we want this done within a month?
Absolutely.
Or, I mean,
yeah.
What time frame would you give
them? On a professional job like that, probably be 3 weeks.
Okay, so by the end of the summer, we should know something.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, that's what I was wanting.
Yeah, Ms. White?
When was the last one done for the city of this type of thing?
I don't know that we've ever had one. Now, in 2012, the work was done for the ISO.
Right.
In 2012, and they do that every 2 years at no cost to us. So sometime this year, they're going to do another one. But if we want our own private consultant to do it, then we'll just have to go find out. Let's see how much it's going to cost. If it's $1 jillion, and we got, well, let's look at the ISO first. If it's not, if it's reasonable, then we'll do it. Mr. Fauci.
Is this a fairly competitive market out there for this? I mean, or is it going to be a pretty limited bidder pool?
I would say it'd be limited.
It's pretty competitive.
Is it?
Okay. It is.
Okay. Well, we'll see. We'll see. On the motion.
On the motion, Ross?
Yes.
White?
Yes.
Taylor?
Yes.
Robinson?
Yes.
Baxter?
Yes.
Fouch?
Yes.
Height?
Yes.
And Witcher?
Yes.
1467, Mayor Smith.
Please call it.
This is a resolution declaring certain buildings, houses, and other structures located at 1307 East 16th Street in the city of North Little Rock to constitute a public nuisance and condemning said structure, providing a period of time for property owner to abate said nuisance.
Have a motion?
So move.
And a second?
Second.
I'm going to call a public hearing on 1307 East 16th. 1307 East 16th. Anyone wishing to speak on that? Seeing none, I'll close the public hearing on the motion.
Ross?
Yes.
White?
Yes.
Taylor?
Yes.
Robinson?
Yes.
Baxter?
Yes.
Fouch?
Yes.
Height?
Yes.
And Witcher?
Yes.
1468, Mayor Smith.
Please call it.
A resolution declaring certain buildings, houses, and other structures located at 2101 and a half Owen Street in the city of North Little Rock to constitute a public nuisance and condemning said structures, providing a period of time for property owner to abate said nuisance.
How about a motion?
So move.
Second.
We'll call a public hearing, 2101 and a half Orange Street. 2101 and a half Orange Street. Anyone here wishing to speak on that? Seeing none, close public hearing on the motion.
Ross?
Yes.
White?
Yes.
Taylor?
Yes.
Robinson?
Yes.
Baxter?
Yes.
Fouch?
Yes.
Height?
Yes.
And Witcher?
Yes.
1469, Mayor Smith.
Please call it.
A resolution declaring certain buildings, houses, and other structures located at 2914 East 2nd Street in the city of North Little Rock, Arkansas, to constitute a public nuisance and condemning said structures, providing a period for the time for property owner to abate said nuisance.
So move.
Second.
I'm going to call a public hearing. There
Hi.
You are. Hi. Go right ahead.
My name is Jacqueline Holmes Beeman. I am the guardian over the property at this time, me and my siblings. I have been working with this property since my grandmother passed, and have been having a whole lot of problems with the area. When I try to do anything in the area, for as plumbing, somebody will come in, go under there, pull it out. It's happening more and more, and since I'm over there, when I'm ready to cut grass, somebody will walk up to me as soon as I finish and want to know if they can cut it and can I, be charged, pay them for it. It's too dangerous over there. I just want to know, what are y'all planning on doing with the zoning? Because I do want to condemn at this time. I've been in and out of court over this for the last couple of months now. The city council, North Park Code Enforcement had seen my mom over there, or she met them over there, and that's when we started getting tickets and citations and all that. But I do want to see it condemned. I just want to know, what are y'all planning on doing with the zoning in that area? It is rough over there. I don't live in the area. That's, you know, but I'm keeping up the taxes and the property. That's all I can do because of the area, the environment. It's too tough for me. It's too rough. What are we planning on doing in that area?
Well, that kind of gets off of what our public hearing is about. We will, you know, tonight we condemn this, then they're going to tear the house down, okay? And you realize that, okay? You know, one of the things that we're trying to do is tear down these dilapidated houses that are creating a problem in some of our challenged neighborhoods. So we're going to fight crime with code enforcement as best we can. And we realize we've got some issues in that 25, 26, 2700 block of East 2nd, and we're addressing them with our police department. So, any other comments?
I have been addressing it with the police department. I'm still over the property, you know, for as cleaning it up and all that. I have to start out cutting grass in the backyard before I can cut it in the front yard. Call the police. That person is gone. I don't know their name. I don't even know, you know, what they look like, being that I might see them and then they're gone. You know, it's dangerous. They run in here. They're hiding in houses. I don't know which way they're coming sometimes. But all I want to know is I'm close to my car where I can get in. Sometimes my husband have to come with me just to cut the yard. You know, two people have to be together at all times. I don't know what to do. Police is never there when you need them sometimes. And then when you call them out so much, it's a nuisance.
All right. I don't know what to tell you. Any other comments on 2914 East 2nd? Seeing none, on the motion?
Ross?
Yes.
White?
Yes.
Taylor?
Yes.
Robinson?
Yes.
Baxter?
Yes.
Fouch?
Yes.
Height?
Yes.
And Witcher?
Yes.
Thank you.
Old 1439, Mayor Smith.
Please call it.
An ordinance waiving formal bidding requirements for the leasing of certain vehicles used by the Knuckle Rock Police Department. First reading.
Move spin the rules placed on second reading.
Second.
On the motion.
On the motion. Ross?
Yes.
White?
Yes.
Taylor?
Yes.
Robinson?
Yes.
Baxter?
Yes.
Fouch?
Yes.
Height?
Yes.
And Witcher?
Yes.
An ordinance waiving formal bidding requirements for the leasing of certain vehicles used by the Knuckle Rock Police Department. Second reading.
Move to suspend the rules and place on third reading.
Second.
On the motion.
On the motion. Ross?
Yes.
White?
Yes.
Taylor?
Yes.
Robinson?
Yes.
Baxter?
Yes.
Fouch?
Yes.
Height?
Yes.
And Witcher?
Yes.
An ordinance waiving formal bidding requirements for the leasing of certain vehicles used by the Knuckle Rock Police Department. Third and final reading.
Move for adoption.
Second.
Ms. Ross?
I always have questions when we, you know, we're waiving, you know, formal bidding or anything. Could Chief Davis just explain just real briefly? I know we do this from time to time, but I know that there's individuals that still question when we waive the formal.
Sure, not a problem. We were leasing vehicles from Landers Toyota. Landers sent us a letter March 24th and said that due to not making any money off of this little project, they have decided to do away with the program. So we were forced to quickly come together. We managed to get something at the same price. The only difference is that the mileage will increase a little bit. We'll have some older cars, which is fine. That's not part of it. It's not a problem. But the price will stay the same as what we're currently paying right now.
And these are non-emergency vehicles, too. I just want to make sure that everybody understands that this is not that we're getting old police cars.
No, these are used by narcotics investigators for the work that they do.
Thank you.
On the motion.
Ross?
Yes.
White?
Yes.
Taylor?
Yes.
Robinson?
Yes.
Baxter?
Yes.
Fouch?
Yes.
Height?
Yes.
And Witcher?
Yes.
On the emergency, Ross?
Yes.
White?
Yes.
Taylor?
Yes.
Robinson?
Yes.
Baxter?
Yes.
Fouch?
Yes.
Height?
Yes.
And Witcher?
Yes.
O1440, Alderman Baxter and Fouch.
Please call it.
This is an ordinance granting a special use to allow a stone and marble cutting in an I-2 zone for certain real property located at 5050 North Shore Lane in the city of North Rock, Arkansas. First reading.
Move to suspend the rules and place it on its second reading.
Second.
On the motion.
On the motion. Ross?
Yes.
White?
Yes.
Taylor?
Yes.
Robinson?
Yes.
Baxter?
Yes.
Fouch?
Yes.
Height?
Yes.
And Whicher?
Yes.
An ordinance granting a special use to allow stone and marble cutting in an I-2 zone for certain real property located at 5050 North Shore Lane in the city of North Little Rock, Arkansas. Second reading.
Move to suspend the rules, place on its third reading.
Second.
On the motion.
Ross?
Yes.
White?
Yes.
Taylor?
Yes.
Robinson?
Yes.
Baxter?
Yes.
Clouch?
Yes.
Height?
Yes.
And Whicher?
Yes.
An ordinance granting a special use to allow a stone and marble cutting in an I-2 zone for certain real property located at 5050 North Shore Lane in the city of North Little Rock, Arkansas. Third and final reading.
Mayor, I have a question.
Question?
Mr. Voiles?
Let's have a motion first.
So moved.
Second.
All right.
Mr. Voiles, I've heard from one property owner concerning this this issue, and she just wanted to make sure that this business was going to do everything on the inside, was not going to be any noise or air pollution as a result of them cutting marble and stone. Is that,
I think this case went bypassed the Planning Commission and came straight here, didn't it?
Pardon me?
Yep.
Yeah, and that's in there. I just wanted to be reassured that this business is not going to be conducted outside of the building, and there's not going to be noise or air pollution as a result of them cutting stone or marble. Correct?
I haven't heard from the applicant. We didn't hold a public hearing on it, so what you're reading is what they have promised, but that's not what has been said at any public meeting.
Why don't you let your sponsors respond to that or call their applicant up?
Alderman, there was some concern about how the process was going to take place, and there was some language added to what you see before you to ensure that those conditions were met.
Okay.
So,
but we have this in addition inside to this?
Well, it's already in
the
body.
It was a change from the original, too.
Particularly, we're talking about how the process is conducted. And if you look here, there's a specific model number that tells you the type of equipment that we're using to conduct that. I hate to use the word cutting, but that's actually what it does. It's just a high-pressure water machine. And you're not talking about dust, you're not talking about noise, that kind of stuff. That's why specifically this is put in the language of the legislation.
Okay. I think the developers here, Gene, you have a problem with this?
Thank you, Mayor, Alderman. I very much don't have a problem with it. I came here to speak in favor of this. The applicant's business model will attract a large number of consumers to the business park. They have a showroom which will show a large variety of products used in remodeling and home construction, and that will complement the other custom plumbing shops that are in the business park and a flooring company. I'm hopeful that the kind of traffic they attract will actually bring some more businesses of this type. My original thought was similar to what you heard from this one person, cutting of marble with a saw does produce a great deal of noise and dust, but the applicant very kindly invited me to their existing location in Little Rock and showed me their equipment. Their new equipment doesn't use a saw, it uses a very modern system, and the part of the zoning rule in I-3 that prohibits cutting of marble just shouldn't apply to this particular process, and they've assured me of that, and I'm satisfied with it. I've seen marble cut with saws, and I've seen it with these folks cut with this completely different, much less noise and no dust. And I urge you to pass this. I think it'll be a great adjunct to the business park and to the city of North Little Rock.
Thank you, Gene. Ms. Ross.
Oh, now I'm just curious. How do you cut it? If you don't mind telling us, if you don't cut it with a saw, what do you use? Is it a laser?
High-pressure water jet.
High-pressure water.
Hot water. Okay.
Ms. White?
I have to say, I got on the website and I researched this and I was fascinated by it. I have just one question for the businessmen. Just, do you recycle the water? Because I realize there's two different, there's recycled or they sanitize it. Which one do you do?
We don't have a recycle
system, but it doesn't use that much water.
Right.
But the only byproduct is sand. I mean, just the little bitty pieces of granite or marble. So,
It was amazing to see. It really was. Yeah.
So you're using high pressure water to cut marble?
Yes. Mm-hmm. 87,000 PSI.
Wow.
Okay, we have a motion.
Wow.
We have a motion.
Thank you. We wish you luck in our city.
I want to come
watch. On the motion.
On the motion to adopt. Ross?
Can we come watch, too? I want to see that. Yes.
White?
Yes.
Taylor?
Yes.
Robinson?
Yes.
Baxter?
Yes.
Fouch?
Yes.
Height?
Yes.
And Richard?
Yes.
On the emergency. Ross?
Yes.
White?
Yes.
Taylor?
Yes.
Robinson?
Yes.
Baxter?
Yes.
Fouch?
Yes.
Height?
Yes.
And Witcher?
Yes.
1441, Alderman Height?
We've already...
Yeah, we've already done that. That was the very first one we did.
We did.
Yeah, that's... I think that's all the legislation.
All the legislation.
Okay, public comment section. James R. is the only one signed up.
Good evening. I realize the city is beginning to be in a tight and have to tighten their belt. I feel if y'all try to up the garbage fee, you could make money other ways. There is things that go on that they don't do a thing about. There's contractors that does not haul their stuff off. They do not haul their materials off. Harold Ford can verify this. If you start making them pay for it instead of letting them put it out on the street and even haul it in from other places other than the city of North Little Rock, you may not have to up a garbage fee. And waste management is doing some interesting things, and I was told by a city leader that you can charge waste management $50 every time you had to come back and pick up behind them. That's great, but you know, maybe we don't need to renew their contract when it comes due. It's a good deal for recycling. I probably put out about two containers, the large ones, every 2 weeks because of what I have to recycle. But please consider, the people that own fixed income may not be able to afford the garbage increase. Everybody running for mayor that I ask said they would not impose a garbage fee. And I hope the Mayor Ramirez is telling me that. But there's other ways to make money. You got people out there that have banners up. They never write them a citation. They never make them pay their little fee. You've got one person has a lot of rent property. He doesn't get a permit unless he's forced to, but yet you won't find him because of who he is. Please consider this when you start thinking about garbage fees. There's a lot of people out there on fixed income, and gasoline and everything going up. It's going to be hard for some of us to afford it. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Ard. Any council members?
Yes, I've got a, you guys will be getting an email about a webinar that I'm getting set up about priority-based budgeting. It will be with sometime in the month of March. The webinar will last about 60 minutes. I'm sorry, May. It lasts about 60 minutes. Then there'll be about another 30 minutes of for question and answers. Priority-based budgeting is something that I attended at the meetings with the National League of Cities. I think it'd be something that will kind of give us some guidance and some ideas on how to move forward with our budgeting issues. So look forward to that email.
Thank you. Any others? Seeing none, how about a motion?
So moved.
And a second?
Second.
On the motion.
Ross?
Yes.
White?
Yes.
Taylor?
Yes.
Robinson?
Yes.
Baxter?
Yes.
Fouch?
Yes.
Height? And Witcher?
Yes.
What did you do?
Yes. You voted out of turn?